So it's about a detective named Dirk Gently who operates based on his instinct and his hunches and his gut rather than logic or clues or facts or any kind of detective training. So it takes him in a bunch of crazy places, and one of them is meeting Todd, who's a hotel bellhop that's involved in the murder, which is the main storyline of season
one.
And I play Amanda, who's Todd's younger sister, and I have a horrible disease, and my storyline is about me coping with that and escaping it.
Great. And then for me, I'm one of the people that Dirk, along with Todd, he pulls into his world of trying to figure out this mystery, how to, you know, determine who committed this murder, basically. And yeah, we have very different ways of working. Dirk, as you know, said, is very, you know, fly by the seat of your pants kind of guy, whereas Farah is very meticulous, detail oriented, in control, trained, you know, so she butts heads with Dirk a lot in terms of their styles. But Dirk, you know, he's got that playful, boyish way about him. And, you know, at the center of it all, it's all heart. He ends up pulling both Todd and Farah into this web to figure out, you know, how we're going to fix it. So, yeah.
Okay, do your characters interact at all?
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
We don't until, like, the
fourth. I don't know, we just had some great scenes together.
We did.
Because our personalities are really conflicting. I mean, you know, she talks to herself and is strong and, you know, has some cuckoo things happening. And I think,
A little OCD. I get it. It's there.
Very
neurotic. You know, she's just sensitive about words.
Yeah.
You know,
My like, daughter's in the house all day, so that's like meeting God. So I'm amused by you, making fun of you, but also loving you, and I like really complicated, fun relationships.
Yeah.
Okay. What is your character's relationship with her brother?
My character's relationship with her brother? He's extremely protective of me, and I love him more than anything on the planet. He is my best friend and my only friend because I don't leave the house. So he's the person that buys me food and takes care of me.
Can you tell us a bit more about how you connected to your characters, or if you don't really relate to them, how you could tap into their personalities?
For me, I learned to drum for this show. I mean, I'm not very good, but I play a drummer, so I was doing some lessons for it, and the way that Amanda loves drumming is like how I love acting in movies, so that passion was already there for me.
Yeah. For me, I feel like something that's really relatable with Farah is that need to be perfect, to always, you know, do what you do well. And when that doesn't happen for Farah, she really beats herself up. It's rough for her, and I can totally relate to that, you know, that perfectionist side of myself, always wanting to do better, be better, self-scrutiny, you know, so that was easy to tap into with Farah. Her other, you know, badass kind of ways, you know, like fighting and the gunplay, that was a lot of fun to learn. That was something that I had to, like, put on.
That's like and me with the drumming.
Yeah, exactly. It didn't come naturally, but we had a lot of work and a lot of help, and it was fun.
And for me, I feel like my anxiety is what it's how I tap into the disease, just like you were saying about trying to be a perfectionist. So there's a lot of cool parallels.
If you had to describe the show in just like a couple of words, like I know it's a lot.
I've been saying it's a detective show with a corgi.
With a corgi.
Yes.
Most memorable moment. Working back off camera?
Off camera?
Off camera? Well, I would say doing an escape room together.
Oh, that was
we all did an escape room and couldn't get out despite being on a detective show.
We did get out. We did get out. They just had to give us like
they
two
had to
extensions.
Give us 15 extra minutes. So we cheated, but
we did
got
it
out,
though. We made it through.
Not really.
Connected.